Sir, suspected means you have identified a person, you have doubt on him, then you have to collect the DNA from him. So then it is called as what? Suspected DNA. Sir, if you take the suspected DNA, so in the suspected DNA, if you take, sir, same number of 49 GT sequences are here, same number of 16 ATGG sequences are here, same number of 51 ATT sequences are here. So here, this is what? Who was killed? Victim means killed. So he died. It may be rape or murder, any case, he died. He or she died. And you got a DNA sequence in the site. In the scene, you got a DNA. Means who is actually murderer or criminal. Then you have a doubt on another individual. So you have to match these two DNAs. So when these crimes in DNA is matched with suspected DNA, you can call this suspected person is nothing but the criminal. So in this way, we can identify a criminal with the help of DNA fingerprinting mechanism. Okay, na? So this is one example how we can use DNA fingerprinting technology for the identification of a criminal. So what we have to do here, we have to take victim's DNA, that is one thing, and we have to take means DNA we got in the site, that may be semen, that may be blood, that may be hair follicle, that may be tissue which is available in the site. We have to compare this DNA we got in the site with the suspected individual's DNA. If both DNAs are tallied, the suspected person is a killer or murderer. If these two DNAs are not tallied, that suspected individual is not a criminal. So that is a DNA fingerprinting application. It is one application. So let us see applications of DNA. This is very important 4 marks question. So applications of DNA fingerprinting technology. Steps involved in the DNA fingerprinting technology is also an important 4 marks question. So application of DNA fingerprinting is also important 4 marks question. Okay, so here first one, it is used for conservation of wildlife. Conservation of wildlife. Sir, if you take the applications of the DNA fingerprinting, it is first used for the conservation of wildlife. So in this process, wildlife DNA is collected and it is stored, and maintenance of DNA records. Maintenance of DNA records. So that is the conservation of wildlife. It is the first application. Second one is taxonomical application. Taxonomical application. So means in the taxonomical application, it is used for the study of phylogeny. It is used for the study of phylogeny. That is taxonomical application. Next one is pedigree analysis. Pedigree analysis means how a gene is going through the generations. The study of inheritance of a gene through the number of generations is nothing but pedigree analysis. So we can imagine how gene is transmitting from one generation to the another generation. So here the entry of gene over number of generations can be studied by the DNA fingerprinting technology, that is pedigree analysis. Next one is anthropological study. So what is anthropological study? Means it is used for the study of origin of man, migration of man, and behavior of the man. Okay, na? Anthropological means man origin, man behavior, man migration. It is only related to the study of human beings' origin, human beings' migration, human beings' behavior. So human migration and his distribution, his behavior. Next one is medico-legal cases. So medico-legal cases means we are seeing so many cases. paternity cases, maternity cases. Paternity cases means who is his father, who is his mother. So that is called as medico-legal cases. Okay, so here to establish good paternity, good maternity in the population. For example, if a baby has means relation with the one individual, whether he belongs to his or not, so that can be identified by the DNA fingerprinting technology. Paternity cases means who is the father, paternity, as well as maternity cases will be solved by the DNA fingerprinting technology. Next one is forensic. So especially these forensic applications to identify the actual criminal, so we use forensic applications. The same example that we have discussed, who is criminal. So here to solve the problem of identification of a criminal, right? So here this is forensic, especially in the murder and some other rape cases, these forensic investigations uses DNA fingerprinting technology for the identification of criminal. So these are the six applications. So DNA fingerprinting is used for conservation of wildlife, DNA fingerprinting used for taxonomical applications, fingerprinting used for pedigree analysis, DNA fingerprinting is used for anthropological studies, that is also used in medico-legal cases, and this also used for forensic study for the identification of the criminal.